Hello, everybody. This is Georgiana and Meredith from Creativity for Kids. And today we are going to play with some big gem diamond painting. So, Miss Meredith, take it away.
Yay, thank you, Georgiana, and thank you, Nicole, and thank you all for being here today. So, as Nicole and Georgiana said, we are doing some big gem diamond painting. And in my hands, I have two themes of big gem diamond painting. One is sweets, and one is magical. So, already I'm asking you for your opinion. Which kit should we do? Please write in the comments which one, either sweets or magical, you would like to see during class today. And while you guys go ahead and write in, I'll open up the kits. And as you can see here, I have some of the samples from our magical. So we've got a rainbow, we have our unicorn, we have our little rainbow star. Oh, okay. I already see someone's voted for magical. And then some of the items from our sweets kit would be something like our sundae or candy. A popsicle, an ice cream cone. Right, it looks like magical is it. Okay, so let's open up the box and see what's inside. So what we have is our handy dandy instructions. We have our sun catcher designs, one of which is a cute little, let's do this, rainbow with happy clouds. The other is unicorn. And then you're given a bunch of stickers. Let's see, where are our stickers? I think our kid didn't come with the stickers. Such as, I think this is a llamacorn, a dragon, a seahorse acorn, a diamond, a kitty corn. This is kind of like a popsicle with wings. And as I mentioned earlier, our rainbow, our unicorn, and our star. So we're also given all of these wonderful rhinestones, which is what you're going to be decorating your stickers and your sun catchers with. Move that out of the way. You're also given these little hangers for your sun catchers. And they have suction cups on them. So you just suction cup them onto your window. And there's actually a little hole that you would hang it off of, like that. And if you don't want to hang them on your window, we give you stands like this. Let's see if it'll pick it up. It's kind of hard to see because it's clear that you slide your sun catcher in and it becomes able to stand up. So we'll get to that in a bit. So how we do this kit though, need a couple things. The tray, the little stylus, and the little bit of wax that comes with it. Let's see where the wax went. Okay, where is our wax? And as soon as I find my little wax, I can, thank you, show you guys how this little stylus, this little tool, this special tool, and the wax work together in order to make it super duper easy for you to create your own Big Gem Diamond painting stickers and sun catchers. So let's go ahead and start with a sticker. So taking a look at our sticker designs, let's ask another question. Do you see a sticker that you would like to see decorated during our class today? We have our panda, our star, our rainbow, our unicorn, our popsicle, our kitty cat. Does anyone see one of these that they would like to see decorated today? And you can see as I move this around, these stickers are foil printed. So they're really rainbowy and really sparkly and shiny to begin with. So then when you add the rhinestones onto them, they're even more sparkly and shiny, which is really cool. Let's see if that picks up. And I think that's as sharp as it's going to get. All right, so let's go ahead and we'll start with the rainbow. Okay. So this sheet is printed with these cool little dots, and it makes it easy to cut out your design. So you just follow the dotted line and cut on the dotted line to the sticker that you want to decorate first. Now, as you're cutting, you might realize that there's a piece of clear paper over the sticker. Now that's there to protect your sticker from getting anything stuck to it, other than the rhinestones. So I just removed the clear paper, and I'm ready to decorate my sticker now. So you can look at the different colors of what's in your sticker, and you can use that as a guide to which rhinestones you're going to use to color it in, or you can just choose whatever rhinestone colors you want and make your own design. So pink, orange, green, and blue. So I already have my pink. And I love these little bags because they're resealable. They have stickiness on them. So if you're not using the rhinestones, and oftentimes I just pour out enough rhinestones for the amount of stickers that I'm creating. And then I just close the bag back up so I don't spill them. That's what I do. So we need a little bit of green. And some blue. Let's see, where's it open up? Here it is. And then some of the clear or the white. So I don't know if you guys noticed, but when I was on the camera earlier, when I was being introduced, I am actually wearing one of these Big Gem Diamond painting sun catchers as a necklace. And I'll show you guys a little bit later what that looks like if you didn't catch it. But that's just one fun thing you can do as a little extra besides what you're given in the kit. So like all the stickers, of course, you can stick the stickers wherever you want, put them on your water bottles, put them on your notebooks, put them on maybe a card to give to your friend. So you can use the stickers however you want. And then the sun catchers, like I mentioned, you can hang them, you can display them, or you can wear them. Okay, so this is our little stylus. Our stylus It's our little tool. It has a hole. Let's see. I'm going to come up close and go away to see if it focuses. Maybe I'll go away and come up close. So there's a little hole in the tip of our little tool here. And that hole allows me to push against this wax and pick up some of this wax. And why that's important is because now your little tool will very easily pick up a rhinestone and place it where you'd like it. So this makes it much quicker than trying to pick up rhinestones with your fingers and place them in such a little area on your stickers. So right now I have like a bunch of the stickiness on my stylus, so I want to kind of push it in so it's a little bit less stuck in there. So just a little bit of the stickiness is sticking out. I know it's unclear, but you can kind of see what I'm talking about. Okay, so you just keep going by sticking the rhinestones right on your design here. And you'll notice that on your designs, like on the rainbow, there are little circles printed. And the little circles are where I'm placing my rhinestones. So it's really easy to follow along as a guide as to where to place your rhinestones. So the designer who worked on these thought of everything and created a really, really fun and easy kit. And I love doing big gem diamond painting because it takes no time at all. And you get these results that are super sparkly and shiny. And like I was mentioning, you can stick these stickers wherever you want to jazz up your notebooks or your note cards or your greeting cards or your water bottles or whatever you want to jazz up. So I was actually just talking to Georgiana about creating earrings out of these stickers. And I think they would be gigantic, but I'm okay with that. Think that would be cool. And I think it's been less than 5 minutes, and I'm almost done with one of my stickers. My cloud. Yay. Almost there. One more cloud left. God, I love these. They're so pretty. These iridescent colors are just awesome. Very magical.
I would say very Meredith.
I like that. There you go. All right, ta-da! All done. All right, so this is what our finished project looks like. Let's see, Georgiana is trying to focus it a little bit more. I don't know if it will focus. Come on, camera, work with us. It seems to be focusing on this rainbow instead. I'll pick that one up here. Yeah. Well, now I have two done, which means I can have matching earrings. Cool. So, whatever you choose to stick it on, you just peel it off the backer paper and you can stick it wherever you'd like. All right, cool. Okay. So, we have one set of stick or one set of stickers. Yeah. That I can use as earrings. Let's do another one. How about if we do? Oh, okay. So it was just Chinese New Year, and This year is the year of the dragon. So let's go ahead and do a dragon. I think that would be a good choice. Year of the Dragon. All right. So we'll peel off the protective paper and put it over there. And we're ready to place our little rhinestones. So just double check the tip of your tool and make sure that you have enough of the little sticky stuff on there. And if you have to kind of like move it over to the center, go ahead and do that. And if you don't have enough sticky stuff on the tip of it, all you do, like how we started, you just push the tool, the tip of the tool, into the wax, and it just automatically picks it up in the center, and now you're ready to pick up your little rhinestones. So here we go. Okay. Lots of green in our cute little dragon. But again, if you don't want to make them green, maybe you want to make them yellow, and you can do that because this is your little dragon.
Or maybe his base is green and he has colorful polka dots on it.
Oh,
Like
you are
colorful
so
scales,
right.
I guess I should
That's
say.
right.
Or
Yeah.
polka dots, I
You
mean.
could be a polka dotty dragon. So, Georgiana, if we were to name our dragon, what would we name him? What's our dragon's name?
I'm feeling Darnell, the dragon.
I don't know if I've ever named any of my creations Darnell before, so I really like that.
That was the first one that popped in my head.
How many Darnells do you know?
Two.
Okay.
I have a cousin and I graduated with somebody.
Okay. I know someone whose last name is Darnell.
Oh, yep.
Yeah. I also know back in the day, like Cowboy Day, many a people, well, maybe not many, but my first name was actually people's last name.
Oh, Meredith.
Yeah. Like John Meredith.
Oh.
Sarah Meredith. Yep.
Well, if you had a dragon, what would you name him or her?
Oh, let's see. Maybe Jesse the Dragon. I'm not sure. That's a cute dragon name too, I think. Jesse. That is the first name that came to me. I don't
Very
know
funny.
why.
I think our dragons would be friends.
Oh, totally. Yeah. Jesse and Darnell. Very cute. Yeah, we are on a roll here. See how quick this goes? It's very like meditative if you get into a rhythm. And it's easy to just like carry on a conversation. You don't really have to put much thought into what you're doing. You're just placing these cute little sparkly gems on the little sticky parts of your sticker. Oops. And you want to make sure that it sticks. There we go. Okay. And I need to open up the yellow and the purple to continue filling in my sticker. So here's a couple purple. I'll put those by the pink. And we need a couple yellow. Right here. All right, we're almost done with Darnell. One, two, three, and purple, and purple. Ta-da! All right. Oh, that's cool. Yay. So if you were to create a little happy Chinese New Year card, you could put this little dragon on it because it's the year of the dragon. So now we have that to use. Right. Well, let's move on to the other activity that's in this kit, which is the sun catcher. So on the back of your instructions, you have these, the sun catchers are printed on here. And why that is because this becomes your guide. So I'm going to actually do the rainbow instead of the unicorn because, as mentioned earlier, I've already done the unicorn and I'm wearing it as a necklace. So I'll show you guys how to use the instructions as the guide for your sticker sun catcher or your sun catcher. All right, again, just like the stickers, you're gonna take the protective paper off. Now, different than the stickers, the whole area of the sun catcher is sticky. So anywhere, like all of everything except for the printed area is sticky. So you're going to put the sticky side up, like facing you, and just place your sun catcher over the guide on your instructions. And now you can see there's like all the little dots. So you're going to just use those dots as a guide to where you put the rhinestones. See, like on the stickers, those dots were printed on the stickers, but on the sun catcher, it's printed on the guide paper, and you use that guide paper to place your rhinestones. So my little tool is all ready to go. And I think I'm going to use a little bit of blue and a little bit of white rhinestones for the clouds. So that means I need to take more blue and put in my little tray. And more white. Put in my little tray. And I don't know if you guys had noticed, but during when you're picking up your rhinestones to place on your stickers, you're picking up the rhinestones that are facing up. So like the rhinestones that are upside down, you kind of have to like move the tray a little bit or like actually pick up the rhinestones and put them back down sometimes to like flip them over. So you want to make sure that you're putting the rhinestones on like that. So I think I'll do an outline of blue and then fill the rest in with the white. And if you don't follow directly on the guides, on the guide dots, that's okay. Like I mentioned earlier, the whole area is sticky. So you won't, it's not a big deal if you don't place all the rhinestones exactly on the dots that are printed. And it's really amazing how sparkly these are when you're finished. They're really cool. So I think one of the times I had done one of these videos, it was Valentine's Day or before Valentine's Day. And I mentioned that online we actually have Valentine's on our website that you can print out, and then you would like add one of your decorated stickers to the Valentine. So then you have a set of Valentine cards to hand out. So just in case you forgot that yesterday was Valentine's Day and you need to give someone a Valentine, that is available to you if you are following along doing this kit today.
I think this sticker sun catcher would be good for St. Patrick's Day.
Oh, that's a cool idea. Yeah, this one is the rainbow. Totally. That is a great idea, Georgiana. So then that makes me want to turn this into a necklace and wear during St. Patrick's Day. That would be fun.
Maybe I have to make one too so that we're twins.
We did now, which I love it. And then I'll make you a pair of rainbow earrings too, and then we would totally
So totally match.
match.
Like, we
I
don't
love it.
usually do that.
I know. Yeah. It's a fun thing that randomly happens sometimes at our work where two people just randomly dress very similarly, and we call it twinsing. And then, of course, we have to take a picture of the two people who have dressed alike. It's fun. And sometimes, like, you might have to kind of squeeze one of the rhinestones in because maybe you didn't place the rhinestone exactly on one of the dots. And again, that is okay. It's all going to be sparkly and awesome anyway. There we go. So almost done with one. See if I can squeeze that in. Yep. Okay. So there's my white paper. Here it is. So just to show you. Oh, I love it. Oh, that's a cool combination. That blue and that white. Oh, that's really cool. Ooh, I love it. It looks like little diamonds. All right. Keep going. All right, so this small little arch here, I'm going to use pink. I kind of want to use pink for all of the arches, but I know that's not exactly a rainbow, so I just really like pink.
Your rainbow can be anything you want it to be.
Right. You couldn't just be all pink and white and purple if you want. Totally true. Oh, that would look so Barbie.
Oh, yeah.
It would be a Barbie rainbow.
Then you have like 10 clouds.
Oh, Ken clouds. That's fun to say. Yeah, this is like easy peasy. Very fun to do. There we go. How about green next? I think I might need to spill out a couple more green. Fill in. So one thing I was thinking about before class today is that these sun catchers, like I mentioned, the whole area is sticky and like there's space between the rhinestones that like after you put the rhinestones on, it's still kind of sticky in between. So I wonder what would happen if we spilled a little glitter over top of it. Just saw what happened there. So we do have some glitter in the room. I don't know if it's thin enough. But I'll keep going with the rhinestones and see if we have any.
One's super thin.
That one's thin. Okay. See if we have glitter that we can kind of add to it as a little experiment here. Like I said, I don't think I've ever tried that. So that might be a really cool look. Georgiana found glitter for me, so we can try it. But I would recommend putting all your rhinestones on first and then glitterizing Otherwise, it'll just be all glitter. Blue next.
You don't need to look too far to find glitter in here.
I know. Right. That is the joy of working in a creative field, a craft company. We have glitter all over the place in a very good way. We have high tolerance for glitter here. Oftentimes, I'll spray my hair with glitter before a Michael's meeting because it puts me in a magical mood. Who doesn't like glitter in their hair? Blue and maybe orange and yellow. Okay, so orange. This is turning out awesome. I love it. Ooh, and the orange is right next to the blue, and those are complementary colors. So this just might look striking. So, friends out here, I am curious if anyone wants to let me know if they are following along or if they've done a big gem diamond painting kit before. So, if you do want to say hello or tell me that you've done one of these kits before, just go ahead and write in, and Georgiana will let me know what you've written. But if you're in the zen of creating, that's okay too. Because this is very meditative, as I've mentioned before. Orange. Okay, yellow. Time for yellow. Yeah, I'll definitely need to spill some more yellow out. Bless you. More yellow. All right, yellow. Come on in. And I'll put my little stickiness back on the tip of my tool and ready to go. Back into big gem diamond placing. So we actually have one of these kits for the holidays as well, and I was able to do that one, and then you can use your stickers to put on your gifts. You could like put them on name tags to gift to people. And that itself is a really fun thing to receive. And I should mention the Valentines that are printables on our website, I believe those go with the sweets kit, the sweets theme. Okay, so I have one more cloud to do. And I think I want to do it just like I did the other cloud because that looks cool. Oh, come on, flip over, flip over. Here we go. I think I have to spill some more out. All right. Whoa, almost missed that one. And I don't know if you guys saw that, but I like to try and kind of like push the rhinestones down all the way, making sure that they're not going to fall off. So every now and then, just put a little pressure down on them just to make sure that they're sticking. I'm going to have to watch this video tomorrow and see if it's as meditative to watch as it is to do. Because I could see it being something pretty relaxing to watch someone doing this. All right, time for the white. Ooh, so cool. Stick, stick, stick. So, yeah, this is a great kit to even do with your friends. Because you guys could take turn using the tool. And you can each choose a sticker that you would want to decorate. So, kind of like a little party craft. That would be fun. You're having a birthday party and you want something fun, and this is like no mess at all, other than just picking up the rhinestones when you're all done. So, quick and easy. And sparkly craft to do for a party. Oh, I'm almost all done. Where will you fit? And right there. All right. I think I can fit one more. Yay, look at that. And this is what the finished result looks like. Oh my goodness, oh, so cute. All right, so what I had mentioned before is possibly adding glitter. So I'm going to take this glitter that I have and I'm going to put it's yellow glitter. So I'm going to put it right by the orange and yellow and just see what that looks like. So I'm doing it over a piece of paper so it will catch the extra glitter. Right. Already I'm kind of loving it. Oh my God. Who would have thought you could make this even more glittery? I didn't know that I could. I love that I can.
We're gonna have to make this big and little diamond painting.
Right, big gem and little glitter diamond painting. All right, and I'll shush it off. Oh, cool. Okay, I'll put that like that so you can see. It really fills in the spaces. Oh my goodness, that is so neat. Let's see, will it focus? Focus, focus. No, it's having a hard time focusing. But you can see it's super duper glittery or sparkly and now glittery. Should I try it again? I wonder. Gosh, that looks like
Maybe it's too sparkly and
it's too
it
sparkly. I
can't
can't focus without the sparkle. Okay, so this is like I mentioned, if you want to hang it up in your window, we give you this really cool little hook with the suction on it. So you would just hook it through the hole. Oh, there. Now it's focused. That's weird. Okay, so now you can see. Glitter, 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 sparkle. Oh, sparkle, glitter. Okay, now it unfocused. Or you can use the little stand, and it has a slit in the center. So that slit will line up with the slit that's on your sticker sun catcher or your sun catcher, and you just slide them, slide them into each other like that. So now it's ready to stand like that. All right, are we able to do a front facing?
On the top.
Okay, so like that. So it stands just like that. Cool. And now I can show you my necklace. Ooh, 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 ooh. So I easily just took a piece of embroidery floss and I threaded it through the hole that you would normally just hang your sun catcher with the hook in the suction. And now it became a necklace. So, all right, friends. Well, I hope you enjoyed our Big Gem Diamond painting class as much as I did. I'm showing you guys how to do it. And I hope that you guys would like to join me again for my next class with Michaels. And thank you, Nicole, and thank you, Georgiana. And then thank you, Michaels, for having us. Have a wonderful day. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.